Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Gabi and today we are gonna do top 10 super affordable perfumes for the fall and winter. I already did a top 10 perfumes, I think it was 15 actually, top 15 perfumes for the fall time, and I included in that video some cheapies, but in this video is gonna be just about super affordable perfumes, and we're not talking about Dior, Chanel, no. Perfumes that are like extremely affordable, and I think they're gonna work amazingly in the fall and also in the winter time. So before we start, if you like this video, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and now let's jump in. First, I have a scent in here that I think in Europe is pretty easy to find, but I've heard that in USA it's not that easy to find online, and I'm talking about, I'm not even gonna try to pronounce this, I Google it, it's Tendre Madeleine, this one, okay, this one. This perfume smells like cinnamon, orange, vanilla cake. I really like it. It's very comforting. It doesn't have the best lasting power. In the opening, it can be a little bit alcoholic, but just like a little bit, like 2 seconds, and then it's gone. It's a gourmand, it's a spicy gourmand, it's a fall winter gourmand. For the price, I can't remember how much I paid for this one. I think it was like £15, £20, something like that for 100 ml. I really like it. I don't have anything like this in my collection. Like I said, it has this cinnamon, orangey, vanilla, like cake. I really, really like it. It has decent lasting power, decent projection. I mean, for the price you can't really complain, but the scent, it's so good. Especially, I think it's very good for the fall time, but in the winter especially, it's very festive, it's very Christmassy, it smells like holiday. It's I really like it. I really, really like it. So the first scent, it's this one. Next we have Zadig & Voltaire, This Is Her. I absolutely adore, not a bottle, I hate the bottle, but I adore the scent. I just adore the scent. This one is sandalwood, whipped cream, some chestnut. It's a very creamy sandalwood. Not too masculine. It has some sweetness from that chestnut. It's so good. It's honestly so good. I really, really like this one. Let me spray it here. I really like this one, and it's pretty affordable. I think like the 50 ml, the one that I have here, it's around £30. On me, this one has very good lasting power, very good sillage. I really cannot complain. It's very creamy, like very, very creamy, almost like lactonic a little bit. Really like this one. Next, we have something similar, and the scent that like nobody talks about. This one, it's Bizarre Dreams from Martinez Perfumes. This one, I'll spray it here because it really reminds me of This Is Her, but this one, it's sweeter and it feels like it has maybe some floral notes. It's not so much, the focus is not necessarily on the sandalwood. Yeah, it's definitely more floral and sweeter, but it's so good. Like, it's so good. It's a bit nutty as well. I really, really like this one. I kind of prefer this one, to be honest. I feel like if you like Zadig & Voltaire and Voltaire, This Is Her, you're gonna absolutely adore this one. It's so good. I think it has some jasmine. Might have some jasmine. It definitely has some jasmine. I really like it. I absolutely adore the scent. Very good, especially for the fall. Amazing. Bizarre Dreams from Martinez. Then we have Lolita Lempicka Lolita Land. I used to talk about this one like quite a lot. Don't smell it from the cap, okay? It smells, I don't like how it smells, but on the skin, this is magic. This scent smells for me like apricot jam with lots of sugar. This is what I'm getting, okay? It's so sweet, like so syrupy sweet. I absolutely adore it. It has amazing lasting power, amazing sillage. I don't necessarily like the bottle. I mean, this is super plasticky, but the scent, if you like extremely sweet perfumes, if you like gourmand perfumes, check this one out. Check this one out, and obviously spray it on skin, because like this, I really don't like it. But on the skin, let's actually spray it on the skin. Let's give it a go. This is what I'm getting, like apricot, peachy jam with like lots of sugar in it. Amazing, 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 amazing. Love it. Lolita Land from Lolita Lempicka. Next, we have a powdery scent. La Mia Perla from La Perla. I absolutely adore the bottle. Like, just look at this packaging. Love it. This is the only powdery scent that it's in my collection. I used to have more, but I realized that powdery scents are not necessary for me. But this one, it's so sexy. I don't know what the notes are in this. I can tell you that it's sweet, super powdery, and very, very sexy. I just adore it. Like, from the moment when you smell it, you're like, like this. This is something. This is something. It's very similar to Valentina Poudre from Valentino. That one is discontinued, but I do kind of prefer this one, to be honest. This one is slightly more powdery and more sexy, but they're very similar. If you have one, you don't really need the other one, but this one is cheaper, and I just like the scent slightly better. So, La Mia Perla from La Perla. We have another scent from La Perla. I talked about this one a couple of times, but nobody else is talking about it, so I think that this deserves more attention. This is La Perla Divina, the gold edition. Okay, this is the bottle. I do really like the bottle, but it really like annoys me because it takes so much space. It takes like so much space. But the scent, like the opening, adore the dry down. Opening, it's champagne and strawberry, and you can definitely smell champagne and strawberry. It smells like a glass of champagne and you have a strawberry inside. But then in the dry down, it's caramel and amber. Usually, I don't really like amber perfumes, okay? I like amber just in designers, and this, it's an amber that I absolutely adore. It's getting slightly powdery. This is not going to be a gourmand. Don't think because it has caramel, it's going to be a gourmand. No. But it's not, it's also not spicy. It's not a dark amber. It's just very soft, very cozy, and it's slightly powdery. Imagine the softest amber with a caramel that's not that sweet, and also something powdery in there. The champagne note like fades away after 10 minutes, and the dry down for me is like the best part. All the time I'm thinking to declutter this, just because the bottle, like I said, takes so much space. I spray it, I'm like, yeah, this needs to go. The opening is just okay-ish. But then when the dry down hits, I'm like, no, 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 no. I need this one in my collection. I absolutely love it. This one retails for like 15, 20 pounds. It's super inexpensive. Give it a try. Give it a try and wait for the dry down, because I feel like the dry down is the best part. So, La Perla Divina Gold Edition. Then we have Nina Ricci Lexta. For the longest time, for me, this smelled exactly the same as La Nuit Trésor from Lancôme. But now I can detect the differences. This one, it's not as smoky as the Lancôme one. And I know it has jasmine. Jasmine is not the main note, but for me, it really smells like jasmine. It smells like a less potent La Nuit Trésor from Lancôme with some jasmine in it. I really like it. And this one, you can find it for like, I don't know, 20, 30 pounds. I think the 50 or the 80 ml. I think the 80 ml is like 30 something pounds. Has very good lasting power on my skin. It can be a little bit medicinal. I've heard people complaining about that. It's not my case. I absolutely adore it. I have no problems with this one. Really like it. If you like perfumes like La Nuit Trésor, but you want something cheaper, check this one out. Nina Ricci Lexta. Then we have a scent that I talked about in my top 15 perfumes for the fall time. Casablanca from Swiss Arabian. Someone said in the comments, why people keep recommending this one? This smells horrible. For me, it doesn't. So I'm gonna keep recommending this, because if you like super sweet vanilla and caramel perfumes. Check this one out. It's very long lasting. It's very powerful. It has amazing sillage. And I really like it. Like, I really like the scent. If you don't like it, not my problem. I really like this one. And I got lots and lots of compliments with this perfume. So that's why I'm gonna keep recommending this. Yeah, love it, love it, love it. Casablanca Swiss Arabian. The next one that also was in that video, Zara Rich Warm Addictive. This is honey, tobacco. Not the best lasting power though. Not the best lasting power, but the scent is good. Like, the scent doesn't smell like a Zara perfume, at least for me. I really like it. I have so many niche, okay? I have so many niche, and I still believe that this smells good. This doesn't smell like a cheap perfume. So if you don't agree with me, okay, I still really like it. Zara Warm Rich Addictive. If you like sweet tobacco, don't think it's dark, don't think it's too masculine. This one is from their men collection. No, it's like a sweet honey tobacco. It's really, really good. Yeah, Zara Rich Warm Addictive. And the last one that I think is more like all year round, but I would not wear this one in the summer or in the spring, maybe like beginning of fall. Ariana Grande, R.E.M. This has something similar to Cloud. It has that airiness. It has that cloud vibe. But this one is very strong on the lavender. So you really need to like lavender. It's not as sweet as Cloud. And it has something sour almost. Yeah, it almost has like some... And sour? Yeah, sour. Not sour. Salt. It has almost like has... two. I cannot talk today. It almost feels like it has salt in it. So it's this fluffy lavender with some salt. It makes no sense. I know. But I really like it. It's very, very comforting. The lavender in this is very comforting. It's not as sweet as the lavender in Mon Guerla, for example, but it's not as unisex as the lavender in Libre from Yves Saint Laurent, at least in my opinion. I really like this one. I hate the packaging. I hate the thing that comes in. It's just horrible. But the scent is good. So our last scent in here, it's Ariana Grande R.E.M. And that was it for today, guys. That was it. Please let me know in the comments down below what perfumes for the fall time you're gonna wear, and they're not that expensive. Everyone can afford them, and if you have any other recommendations, please let me know, okay? That was it for today. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and like always, I'm gonna see you in my next one. Bye-bye.